How does it feel when you walk past the cinema and you see your work on a poster?
Oh, it's great. Are you kidding me? The film still photographer, like myself, we're probably some of the most recognised photographers in the world, and no one knows the names. I'm Jasin Boland. I'm a motion picture still photographer, which means that I do all the unit photography on films.
They are some of the most recognisable posters in the last 15 years, and you've almost definitely walked past them at the cinema. And they were all shot by this Australian photographer.
Take us on the guided tour.
This is some of my favourite posters. Obviously, Bourne Ultimatum's a favourite poster, and then Matrix, which is kind of funny because I had to buy this online, signed by Larry and Andy, but now Lana.
The Matrix. So you're the guy behind the iconic Matrix poster?
I guess so. Well, the Matrix for me, that was an interesting process because I think they needed to hire a local stills photographer, and at that stage, there wasn't too many of us around in Australia.
Do you want to know what it is?
No one knew the phenomenon the Matrix was going to be. And then when the film came out and it was just absolutely colossal, and literally for the next few years, I could have just had, you know, a resume with one line, The Matrix, and I probably would have got hired. The golden rules of my job, patience and timing. You know, the amount of times that I've got the shot of the day in the final 5 minutes is amazing. And I enjoy that. I don't like to walk away from anything. And I like the filmmakers to sit there and go, man, that's really cool.
You know what I love? You've actually captured, in my mind, the iconic Tom Cruise running face here. This is it. This is the... somewhere you just need to produce a book of Tom Cruise running.
From Cruise to Denzel Washington to Charlize Theron, there pretty much isn't anyone famous left that Jason hasn't photographed.
Hey, is Nick Cage a bit nuts?
No, he's Nick Cage. To watch him work is amazing.
Because he's a bit nuts.
He does a particular kind of crazy.
Yeah, but he does do particular types of things. And, you know, he becomes his character. You know, he lives it. He is the ghostwriter for the whole time that he's the ghostwriter.
Like, I mean, come on. He's a bit nuts.
That was amazing to watch, though.
This is a very important movie in your life, isn't it?
Yeah, Bourne Supremacy, because it's where I met little Mr.'s mummy, Maria.
Maria was a last-minute extra on the Bourne Supremacy, and before the two even met, Jason saw her through the lens.
My beautiful wife. So trippy looking at that photograph, because that literally is the moment that I met her. Meeting Maria was, I mean, it's a highlight of my life, but Bourne Supremacy was also a highlight of my career. Matrix was the initial push into getting hired in Australia, and Bourne Supremacy was the push into going global, I guess.
I'm gonna ask you some simple questions. You're gonna answer me honestly, or I swear to God, I'm gonna kill you.
These are now the iconic Bourne images. It's him in motion. It's him stressed, looking slightly off camera.
Well, a lot of Bourne, I go into shooting with a slow shutter, and because I want to get that sense of movement. I have a theory with every film that I work on. I try and, you know, like some things might be shadows. Bourne is all about movement.
That's interesting that you're kind of crystallising a movie down to a couple of key kind of visual motifs in a way.
I tell the director's story, but I do it...
using your language.
In my own way.
Every year, Jason, Maria and 6-year-old Hunter pack up and they travel the world. From China with Jackie Chan to Namibia with Tom Hardy. They are the blockbuster gypsy family.
Work is part of my life, not my life is part of my... Hold on. Life is part of my...
Let's go for take two on that one.
Let's go for that one again. My family life is pretty awesome. Maria and Hunter are always there with me, and he's been on the road with us since he's been 2 months old. And you know, he's getting an amazing education. You know, he's showing his teacher where Namibia is, you know, talking about animals that kids have only seen in books. And you know, he's had elephants sniff him. He's, you know, patted a cheetah. He doesn't live in a box. He knows that there's a big wide world out there, and hopefully it'll benefit him when he's a little bit older to realise that if he wants it, he can have it. I don't look at myself as being an artist. I think I'm learning to be more of an artist, but there's nothing artistic about my work. I'm a storyteller and I'm there helping the director to tell his story and the filmmakers to get their vision out there. And you go and see these unbelievable films, and I get to go and see the theatre version of it. You know, I'm seeing it live, and it's incredible to be allowed on these sets and watch this incredible process of filmmaking. And being a part of that living organic creature just like gets me, you know, I like it a lot.